Hello Gemini, how are you doing? Hope you're doing great. I'm your host Vikas Chandra Pedarella. Let's do your reading for the month of August 2020 for Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus and Jupiter signs. I'm going to look at the cards for you and see what we have the month of August. Wow, that was actually very fast and it wanted to come out. Four of Swords. You're definitely waiting for this month to unveil itself, meaning you're just waiting and staying there and you want to see how this August month will bring you into your life. What are the energies that will bring to you? And I feel like you're just waiting, and I also feel like you already know few things that might uncover in the month of August, and you're just waiting for that. And you're also very wise, is what I'm saying. You know things which many people will be waiting to get to know the information, but you already know prematurely. Okay, is what I'm saying. You definitely know few secrets which oftentimes will be uncovered in the future, and people will get to know either ways, but you know it way before the time. Is also what I'm seeing. Interesting, very interesting. I can also see with regards to home life, you already know a lot of things. You're learning things with regards to home. It might be interior decorating, it might be painting on walls. Interior designing is what I'm seeing. You're trying to learn that. It might be a new skill. Emperor as the second card. Even Libra got Emperor as their second card. And you might actually be connecting with Libra, and you might actually be waiting for that Libra person to come to you and express their feelings or their emotions with you. Check out Libra reading. I'll actually mention in the annotations. You have to check it out if this is a situation where you're actually trying to approach someone and it's very hard for you to get their attention or connect with them. If that's the case, definitely you have to watch Libra reading in the month of August. I'll actually mention in the annotations. You have to definitely check it out, because I told them there's definitely a significant person they might have who are trying to reach, but it's very hard. So if that's the case for you, then you have to check it out, because even they got Emperor card as the second card, and things doesn't happen just like that. Okay, there's 78 cards in the deck. I'm taking 10 cards out of it, and you getting the same card at the same position, it's really significant. Okay, and you being air sign also, I can see it definitely relates. You two guys are air signs and you got swords in the reading, four of swords, which represents stalemate literally, and I represented in the video in the reading. I told someone is just waiting, being in stale. Okay, that want to come out. Hierophant, yeah, you're learning many things. Emperor next to Hierophant, you're very very educated. You might actually completed, you might actually be very very wise. For sure, even Four of Swords is a wise person. Very, very wise, Four of Swords. He'll be just sitting in the bed, four swords will be facing at him, and he doesn't do anything. He'll just look at the swords and just relax in the bed. That's how wise he is. That's how confident he is. Even in this, you can see the four swords are pointing and facing on top of this deer. And it's very calm and peace. It definitely knows the sword is facing it, but it's very happy and peaceful. That's how wise it is. And Emperor and Hierophant, it's one of the most beautiful and very intellectual cards to come out. You can see Four of Swords, Emperor and Hierophant, very very intellectual here. You might be a doctor also. You might have finished your PhD. You're definitely a doctor, is what I'm saying. a doctor and a spiritual person who is definitely spiritual as well as completed his PhD, like Deepak Chopra. Okay, definitely that level of knowledge you definitely have. Guys, you have to, for majority of you, you have to check out Libra reading, okay? Because even they got this Five of Pentacles, and I feel like universe is trying to connect you and Libra together in the month of August. I can't assure you it will happen, the connectedness in the month of August, but definitely it will take some time for a few of you. But universe is trying to align itself for you two guys to connect each other. And due to this pandemic situation, definitely it's very hard to get together and have the luxury to even communicate face to face with each other. So check out Libra reading. I don't want to say everything about Libra in your reading. For few of you, the World card, I told about travel and you got World card. Yeah, this is the situation, guys. Check out Libra reading for sure. This is the message I'm getting again and again. That's definitely a signal. Libra is also completion of a cycle. So if there is a bad cycle, good or bad, either way it's ending and something new is going to start, and universe is providing that new energy. Something definitely new is going to start, and it will definitely take you away from this Five of Pentacles. You won't feel this Five of Pentacles movement again. The cycle has ended, Gemini. You won't feel sad. The things are going much better. Days are going much better. You're definitely moving forward. The cycle is definitely moving. And World card is definitely ending of a cycle. I told you something new is going to start. You got Ace of Swords. Ace of Swords is definitely new beginning. No surprise, you can ask any tarot reader. They'll tell you. They won't be much surprised when cards are speaking as they are representing the reading and presenting you the reading and letting you know the meanings and doing the reading. And when cards also speak this way, there's no surprise. You can ask any tarot reader. It's so fascinating, it's so magical. I don't know how it works. And I know, as a tarot reader, I know there are 78 cards in the deck. Each card has very, very different meaning. If you compare Two of Swords and Ace of Swords, it has very, very different meaning. And while I'm saying something, exactly those cards pop out. And if you look at the meaning and what I'm telling you, I'm just not making up the keywords of these cards. I'm just representing as a sentence and telling you. It's the whole story which unfolds naturally, and it's kind of amazing how it matches. Okay, like Four of Swords, Emperor, it definitely matches as an intellectual person. Hierophant, very knowledgeable, PhD level of knowledge, almost like Deepak Chopra, amount of intelligence. Libra got a Five of Pentacles, Emperor. I told them about stalemate, and you got Four of Swords, etc., etc. Next is Ace of Swords. I told new beginnings, definitely some new beginning is going to start. Definitely a new beginning is going to start in the month of August. You'll become much, much knowledgeable. It's definitely saying in the month of August, it's all about your mind, Gemini. It's all about your mind. You can see this Four of Swords. It is Swords. Sword is the mind. It was Ace of Swords, the Thor hammer. It's all about the mind. It's the thunder. Thunder is very, it has great knowledge. Many people don't know the information what the thunder holds. And knowledge is represented based on the level of intelligence and information you have. That is what represents knowledge. And it is very clearly seen with thunder. It has so much of information. Well, it is projecting. It's very fast and has so much of information. Because if you look at the world, wow, this is beautiful. If you look at the world, take this as the earth, and this is the thunder, right? Ace of Swords. You can check these two cards out. This is the world, this is the earth, and this is the where the thunder hits in the ground of the earth from the clouds. When thunder hits from the opposite side of the gravitational field, exactly if the thunder hits, the sound which is produced by the thunder, if you take that from the gravitational field, which looks like this from the torus field, like a sea, exactly opposite to that, after traveling to this, all the sound, all the neutrons, after traveling, it'll actually divide itself. It'll actually become very noisy while traveling. And if you actually record the noise over here, you'll definitely record something in the meter. There'll be a shake of the meter. Sometimes we can't hear it, but from the opposite side of the gravitational field, who are living in the other place, from the opposite side, they can hear the thunder which is happening from the other side of the earth. Okay, that's how powerful the thunder is. And so much of neutrons of knowledge, that's the neutrons is nothing but the knowledge, so much of neutrons will travel even after traveling the high amount of gravitational field across the earth. It will actually make a sound. That's how much of power the thunder has. And we even don't know nothing about it. People don't know nothing about it. And there's the Thor hammer. You can see Thor is very strong, even in the movies. Now, Nine of Cups you got as the next card. You will feel emotionally happy. What did I just tell you? You won't definitely, you will get out of this Five of Pentacles energy, because the cycle has ended, Gemini. That's it. And you will definitely move away from this Five of Pentacles energy, get into a new cycle, and the Ace of Swords, power of the thunder, will light on you, and it will always be like a guidance for you. Thunder is the guidance, right? It will light up and create this awakening. It's like waking up. Thunder will always wake everybody with its sound and intensity of light. And Nine of Cups is definitely happiness, feeling emotionally happy. And look at these two cards. The transition has happened because of this World card. The cycle has ended, right? This thunder is always, it's cracking open, it's a crack. Thunder will always form like a crack, right? It has to break away. The cycle has to break away, and some new beginning is gonna start, right? I said break away and you got Five of Swords. Look at this, it's cutting off, it's breaking. You can see one sword over here in the Five of Swords. I said break, it means cut, okay? And this is the sword over here which you are seeing. This Ace of Swords is nothing but over here, with the Ace of Swords in the Five of Swords. It's cutting the cord. You might be dealing with a karmic partner also. I've told many times, I'll actually be making a video, separate video, in the future, because it's very so much of knowledge is definitely required to understand karmic cycles and karmic cords, etheric cords, karmic partners, karmic relationships, even karma. It's very hard to analyze. So I'll definitely be making a video on that in the near future for sure. I have to definitely plan on that. And if this is the cutting the cords, etheric cords. And if you're trying to connect with the karmic partner, it might happen that you'll either connect and have a healthy cord, or if negative cords build up, which is not allowing the proper flow of energy reach to each other, then definitely the cord has to be cut. Okay, it has to be cut, because even the cord, if you're trying to pull a thread, eventually because of the pull from the either from the two sides, it will be cut. Okay, naturally. And etheric cords is something we can't see through our visual eyes. From the red and blue lights which we see, it doesn't appear. It is the black and white. It's not red and blue, etheric cords. Only a person who unlocks his third eye can actually see from the third eye what is going on and what etheric cord, where the etheric cord is placed from the other person to you. Okay. Once you actually connect with a new person for the first time in your life, an etheric cord builds up with you and the other person. And depending on the initial contact, this is the reason they say first impressions, right? You have to make a good first impression, they say. That's the reason. Because as soon as you connect with anybody for the first time, an etheric cord will be developed with the other person to you, so that the information and channeling will be happening smoothly and there will be no other entities that is interacting or controlling the situation of you and the other person. Because with communicating and sharing emotions with you and the other person in between, definitely there will be lot more spiritual beings and lot more energies that will that might be interrupted, okay, which are sensitive to your signal which you emit. They are nothing but they don't have the bad intention to interrupt, but they might be sensitive to that, to your signal, so it might get interrupted. So an etheric cord will be built up, and depending on the first impression you make, the etheric cord will become strong, and that etheric cord will be stable for the rest of the connection. Okay, that's how our relationship goes on in our entire life. It is not one etheric cord, so many etheric cords will be built up. And Seven of Pentacles, I can definitely say Nine of Cups and Ten of Pentacles, in between you got Five of Swords. Now you will be definitely emotionally happy without cutting the cord, but if you cut the cord, if the cord is cut, you can definitely achieve emotional victory and finances, is what I'm seeing. If the cord is cut, you can see the finances will grow very, very fast. It's because of the energy which you have is being utilized by yourself in a much more efficient way, and it is not wasted with the other person. That's the meaning. And that car literally was a flyer, and it was also falling down. Definitely you have to check out Libra reading. They got these three cards: Mother of Swords, Five of Pentacles, and Emperor card over here. Check out Libra reading if it resonates what I'm telling you. Very, very interesting actually. Mother of Swords come out after Ten of Pentacles. When this pentacle starts to grow, you might actually go out of balance. You might actually spend a lot. You might get a bonus salary in the month of August also. For few people, depending on the cord cutting ceremony which is happening naturally or purposefully, either ways, depending on that, finances will grow, and it will also go out of balance, is also what I'm sensing psychically, because after the cord is cut, it has to heal, the wound has to heal, but the energy flow will be little bit emitted outside, and that is through yourself spending a lot on yourself, splurging also unnecessarily. And Mother of Swords represents your mother will take care of that with her insight and her knowledge, depending on your situation, for sure. Chariot, you have to check out Libra reading, guys. There 1, 2, 3, 4, yeah, 4 is a lot in a reading, right? 4 out of 11, you're kidding me. There are 78 cards in the deck, guys. Chariot represents movement. You two guys will definitely move, not together, it may be together, but definitely you two guys will move into a better place, is what I'm saying. And I feel like that is what we all need, right? We have to hope the other person will also reach to their goal and destiny and to a safe place. And you yourself, you have to hope that you'll be reaching to a very comfortable place. And it's all about balance. If things won't work out, universe will help you get into another lane and try to gear into another path. Okay, That's how everything works. It is trial and error method. That's how universe works. Since it will provide you something if you're happy and if it works out by two entities, it will be fixed. And if it doesn't work out, trial and error, it will take you another destination and another experience. That's how we try to learn new things, right? Okay, this is all I have for you, Gemini. Such a beautiful reading, actually. Definitely few ups and downs are there. You have to definitely be in this Four of Swords. If you're definitely, it's very hard to move forward. It's alright to just stay in a stalemate. It's one of the best cards, Four of Swords. Trust me on this. It's better to do nothing at this time if you're not sure. It's better to not take any decision if you're claustrophobic or if you're not sure. It's better to just be in a stalemate. And you're definitely wise, is what I'm saying. I told you in the beginning, you're definitely wise and you know few things which will unfold even before it does. So you know things will go naturally. If things have to happen, it will happen, or else, you know, chariot. You'll definitely move either ways. That's how you know. First card and the last card. You definitely know this chariot will take place. Deep down, this is the bottom of the deck. So that's all I have for you, Gemini. Such a beautiful reading. If you want to watch it again to get more clarity, you definitely have to watch it. And also, majority of you, 90%, I can assure you, you might be dealing with a Libra. Either Sun, Moon, Rising, Libra. And what and all I have told, if it resonates to you with regards to that, then definitely you can check out Libra reading. As I said, I'll mention in the annotations. Do check out. Even cross watchers are also welcome in my readings. Other tarot readers may not do that, but in my readings, definitely cross watchers can watch. They're open, and there's nothing to be afraid of. Until then, I'll see you guys in the next one. Thank you, Gemini.